Hello, my name is Simon. I'm from CodeTwo, and I'd like to show you how to create an offline backup of multiple Office 365 mailboxes. Office 365 itself has no external backup options, so companies that need a backup solution for security, disaster recovery, email continuity, archiving, or simply cannot keep all eggs in one basket have to use a third-party product. This is why we developed CodeTwo Backup, which downloads Office 365 mailboxes data to your local network, letting you securely store it for as long as you want, browse it, and restore everything or selected items only. Okay, let's see how this works. All I need to get started is a 64-bit Windows-based computer with Windows 7 and up, or Windows Server 2008 and up, and with internet access and global admin permissions to my Office 365 organization. Okay, when I launch the program for the first time, this is what I see. The dashboard, which doesn't show much at the moment because nothing has been backed up yet. And I can cycle between the views here, but I'll get to this later when we have our first backup job running. So the easiest way to create my first backup job is to use the Get Started box here that will open up the backup job wizard. There are two options that I could choose from. I'll go ahead and pick the default continuous incremental backup option. I'll skip the activity period scheduling step here. And this is where I connect this particular job to my Office 365 tenant. I only need to provide my global admin's credentials here. And I can almost hear you folks asking this question. Can I connect different jobs to different tenants? Of course you can. You can back up multiple Office 365 tenants using this tool, even including Exchange on premises. Okay, once I'm connected, all mailboxes from this tenant are listed, and I can choose which ones I want to back up. Let's pick just two mailboxes from this job to make it quicker. Now it's time to select a storage location for my backup. It can be any local or network folder. I don't want to apply any time filters or to exclude any special folders in this job. And here I have the summary of my first backup job. Clicking finish will close the wizard, open the backup view, and display this prompt message to let me know that the program is operated by a Windows service, so I don't have to keep it open all the time to keep the jobs running. And here's another asking me if the job should be started right now. So the backup job is running now. On the right-hand side, I can see that cycle number one is in progress. It's currently creating a full backup of this mailbox, and it's supposed to back up two mailboxes in total in every cycle. Okay, I can see that the next cycle is in progress, which means the first full backup has been completed, and I can switch over to the backups view to take a closer look at the mailboxes. And here they are. I can now browse these mailboxes manually or use the search fields to locate the items that need to be restored. What I can see here mirrors what I have in these mailboxes in Office 365. If the backed up items are modified on the server side, each backup cycle will download the latest version of these items and their version history will be available here. As you can see, I can restore entire mailboxes, folders, or just single items. In each case, the procedure is the same, so I'm going to go ahead and restore just a single folder. A similar wizard to the backup job wizard pops up. It starts with a job name, and then I can verify the source data and move to the most important part, which is choosing the target location. I can restore this folder to its original location, to another folder in this mailbox, or any other mailbox in this tenant. Or I can even restore it, or migrate it to be more precise, to a different Office 365 or Exchange on-prem organization. The program will also be equipped with export to PST feature in the future. Okay, here I can set up override and version options. Let's stay with the default options and restore the latest version of these items from this folder. And the summary, and here we go. Yes, started now. The program switched back to the jobs view and my restore job has been added to the list of jobs. It's finished now, which means my folder has now been restored to Office 365. So this is all it takes to create a backup of your Office 365 mailboxes and then restore items that were lost in the cloud. I promised to get back to the storages and dashboard views. So now it's a good time to do this. The storage view shows all the folders I created for my backups. I can easily manage all my storages from this view. And the dashboard view shows critical alerts, the status of the program, the jobs, as well as storage folders that I have created and the defined connections to Office 365 or Exchange tenants. You can get your 30-day trial of Code2 Backup for Office 365 from code2.com right now and create your first Office 365 mailboxes backup even today. Thanks for watching.